Hi, I'm Pat Cohn, and this is part of my Let's Play series for Fallout 4. So here, I wanted to briefly show you what I've done with Jamaica Plain, at least so far, and afterwards we're going to go to Nuketown, USA. So one of the challenges with imagining settlers living in a big, open world like this, where you can imagine attackers coming from any angle, is how do you diminish that concern? And one of the ways that I like to do that is to reduce the number of directions that somebody can approach my settlement from. And with that, you have walls. So here what I've done is I've taken this stairway down into this park area and blocked it off with a large set of walls. And I've similarly extended that wall around here to block off this entrance. I have not yet done anything with this open area here. I plan to, but I don't have enough stuff going on here yet. I've also blocked off this doorway because that's the end of the buildable area, and there's no real sense in leaving that open. And I've built some construction. What are these called? I've built a scaffold up to this building. This is actually outside the buildable zone, but I like having it easily accessed as another place you can go. So I think the wall itself is the barrier for what you can step in, or for what you can build on, what you can't. It's a bummer that you can't just stick a chair up there and maybe a cot, but oh well. I've blocked off a little bit of the angle here, so basically you have this doorway, you have this kind of corridor here, and then you have that open area back there right now. You can see I've built a power plant up here to power my defense system, and also to add a little bit of light in here. This is a central gathering space. And I've made a performance area by using well-placed, raised floors with some concrete under them. You can't move this, otherwise I would definitely move it out. And I have a pylon so that I'm able to build other stuff. I left this largely intact. And back here, I have my farm, so that my settlers will have something to eat. There's an entryway directly into the farm. I kind of went back and forth on whether I wanted to have this or not. The issue with not having it is it means that people are always walking through the home there, and that felt a little bit odd. I'm not quite sure what you're doing there, dude. You're crazy. He's probably crazy. Anyhow, moving up, we have where he lives. He's my single settler here. I felt that I had to give it at least a little bit of life. He sleeps on a cot here. There's a little bit of a rug. I cleared out all the rest of the stuff in this room. Then I built an extension out here for him to have a place to sit and store stuff. And then a place for him to relax. And then there is our defense system up here. Now, beyond that, if you're down here, I used a way that the walls didn't quite line up right to give us a bathroom. This wall is maybe not as solid as I would like it to be, but I have sealed it off, and we have a toilet and a bathtub. And this here is just to give the settlers a little bit of shade, because it probably gets hot, and it would be nice for them to have a place to rest when they're not doing their farming stuff. So I have made that arrangement. So far we've left this intact. There's not a lot else going on here right now. When we get more settlements, we'll probably expand this further. But for now, that is what we have. I can imagine I might stick a market in here once I have the ability to do markets. I don't think I have that ability now. And in any case, I don't have the ability to do some of the nicer markets. What is it? Stores? Yeah, I don't have local leader yet. And that's what you need to actually set up markets. So, we're going to Nuka World. And we're near the tail end of MacReady's association with us, because we've done his two special quests. And now we're just waiting for his affinity with us to top out. Then we'll be able to dismiss him. The reason that I decided to go to Nuka World is that there's a companion. When you max out affinity with a companion, you get their perk. And there is a super, super useful perk for the Nuka World companion that I would like to get. Unfortunately, the way that you ordinarily unlock Nuka World is you listen to the radio. But the whole series is a game series with a whole lot of bugs. And unfortunately, a bug has prevented me from listening to the radio and getting what I need. Although, it's interesting seeing the fading in and fading out there. So I'm not going to be able to listen to the radio and unlock that quest. So instead, I just happen to know where it is. That's how I'm going to get there. We are just walking west from the Lonely Chapel. And here we can see, up ahead of us, we see some signs for and buildings for Nuka World. And we finally see a quest marker. We see a sculpture of buildings up there that are shaped like soda bottles. I don't know if we can actually walk to these or not. It's looking like not. But we can definitely walk over there. Or at least we should be able to. The game is often a little bit finicky around the edge of the world as to where you're allowed to walk and where you're not. Actually, let's put this up because we don't need it yet. And having a gun out slows you down. So you can imagine the residents of Boston, they take their super high-rise highways, and they drive out here to the Nuka World Transit Center. I'm not sure if I can actually keep walking west or not, or how far. This feels like a natural border. I'm guessing I won't be able to go further than here, more or less. Oh, maybe I'm wrong. It would have seemed to be a natural cutoff point, but apparently they didn't want the map boundaries to be quite that close to the transit center. This is the edge of the world. Okay, and so we are on the other side of the transit center now. And this is where we're going to go to Nuka World. We have to be careful because, if I remember right, there are some photos, maybe? We have some nice area back here in case we need to run here. Some buses to offer some cover. And there it is, a gunner assault run. So for this, I'm going to use a tactical Tesla rifle.
No one investigates that signal until this place is secure. If I see anyone violate protocol and enter that transit station before we're set, I'll have your head. Now pick
Somebody's
up the pace.
Talking.
I want to be able to report back to Cypress ASAP.
Probably raiders. Okay, so there's a lot more going on here than I remember. Let's see what we can do to even the odds. Some of the plot around this area doesn't make a whole lot of sense in that the radio stuff is still being run to
Come
entice
on,
people
just leave
there.
It.
To entice people to visit Nuka World. Now, actually, what I might try and do is slip up.
What?
Or slip over.
Yeah.
By insight.
Damn.
Now.
Ambush. Ambush. Defensive protocols engaged.
Because otherwise least I'm really good. It's mediocre armor. I think my armor is at least pretty decent. This is a direct command. I need to lock pick on this machine, because otherwise this would make absolutely no sense.
Sweet.
Suspect that lockpicking in Mortal Kombat is just something that nobody can do.
Damn it!
That person has a stealth block. That's not good.
I'll make this quick.
Fortunately, stealth boys don't last forever for you, and they don't last forever for your opponent. So if you ever see somebody in Fallout using a stealth boy, just run away. That is somebody in combat. Good. McCready has taken it from that angle. I should take it from this angle. Recently, that there are some modders who are going through the world of Fallout and trying to do exactly what I'd hoped that somebody would be doing, that is, trying to refurbish the world and turn it into what it was before the war. I just think that would be so interesting. Like, I know a lot of fiction, you kind of have to do a careful mix of making an interesting world and making an interesting plot. And it's easy to burn out if you have too much of one or the other. But for me, the plot, I tend to be more interested in worlds than plots. Do I have anything I can crop that I don't need so much? Because I've picked up way too much good armor here. Junk. Connecting rods are way heavier than they are valuable. Okay, so there's an elevator, which I think just takes you down.
Going up. Level
that is
McCready.
can find him, we can get him to take
going
this stuff.
Down. Level one.
This place has definitely seen better days. Okay, so I think we might have wiped out all the raiders here. Fortunately, we've completely filled up on everything. So, this area is kind of a preview of the rest of Nuka World, and that there is all sorts of loot. It's an area that has absolutely no end to it. Which is kind of nice if you're still early enough in the game that you get excited by building stuff. You left. Okay. Okay. So, we've got a lot of. Good
hey. Oh, you shouldn't have.
Good stuff, even, I was operating under the theory that I should try and avoid giving MacReady armor, because you can't just transfer all the armor by tapping the button super quick. You actually have to be careful not to take MacReady's armor off, but at the same time, the junk that I had was not quite enough of the weight that offloading it all put me under. So, we're back home. And pop off this stuff. Power fists are kind of fun. I like to give them to Kate. Reminded me of one of my favorite characters from Fallout New Vegas, in that she's really combat-oriented, but she's not quite as intelligent, or at least I would assume not. She's definitely not as well-trained as Veronica. At some point, I'll have to come back and do something with some
heads up.
Stuff. Okay, coming on their stuff, and then there's the jump.
Well,
and we can drop off some of the dirty water. So initially, when you make it to the Nuka World, you're making a commitment to stay there for a little bit. So I want to make sure that I am well armored enough and have what enough of what I want. I get some crag stuff. Maybe a few more Molotovs, just because they're super useful, particularly in the entry areas. I'm not gonna try and pretend that
all systems are go, man.
I think the world is new to me. Okay, we're all filled up and we are ready to go. Off to Nuka World. Imagine the pre-war families driving in, coming like this. I guess there's maintenance areas back there that where they wouldn't go, and then they would turn and pull into one of these parking lots, now collapsed. Obviously, they wouldn't have been collapsed back then. They would pull in and so on. And then they would come over here and catch the train. We should have looted that before I went down there. What was this? Oh well, can't have everything. Maybe maybe they would come over here and some of them would use the restroom before they hopped on the train. And here we have...
Jesus, shit. They're gonna die.
What happened to you?
Raiders. That's what... Those bastards have my family. You gotta help me. Please.
You look terrible.
Tell me about it. My family and I found out they're a raid. I managed to escape.
Let me help you first.
No, no. I'll be fine.
You're not thinking straight.
Jesus, they're running out of time.
Uh-huh. The caps, you got yourself a deal.
Oh, thank God. Here, take this. It's the password to the monorail. The fastest way to get to Nuka World is to take the Nuka Express.
All right, so we actually
but
just
I shut
got
it down
so up to talk.
Find the control terminal. And...
Hold up. I think we need to talk.
Top affinity.
I hope nothing's wrong.
Wrong? No. Uh-huh. I've been waiting for the right moment to talk,
mm-hmm.
after helping me get here.
Uh-huh.
I know a carved toy soldier is a strange reward for risking your life.
If it's special.
You're welcome. My wife Lucy
right?
never could bring
uh-huh.
the soldier story was the best.
Hey.
I had a feeling.
Uh-huh.
We made them.
Okay.
They were
so
honorable. Took everything.
We're now going to be briefly.
You may have lost.
Maybe.
Sure.
Damn, I miss Lucy.
Mm-hmm.
No matter how bad things got. Gave me when she died. Then I met you. You have the world's problem. I just...
Hey.
And I aim to keep... Anyway,
uh-huh.
taking all that weight off my shoulders makes... Speaking of which...
So we get Killshot, which is actually one of the better
be
perks in the game. I think it got nerfed slightly. So we're going to change of plan and actually drop him back off at... drop him back off at... Red Rocket, and grab Ada, because this is actually a fairly dangerous combat area, and Ada is one of the best companions you can ever have for combat. I didn't actually expect it to work out this way, but obviously or I wouldn't be making it. Drop off stuff again, including weird, for some reason I thought we had another heavy thing to drop off. Apparently not. Okay, we're gonna go find
unidentified intruder detected. Beginning search.
Kind of disgusting. Okay, so our rush devil is gone.
Hey, Ada.
A pleasure to see you again, ma'am. Are you ready to depart?
Time to hit the road.
Understood. Please, lead on.
Okay, so MacReady is staying at the park. Staying here. I have Ada with me, and we're heading off to the Nuka World Transit Center, where we are going for reals this time to Nuka World. too jumpy there. Got my head cut.
Nuka World is proud to be the only East Coast location serving Nuka-Cola Quartz and Nuka-Cola Victory. Try one today!
Okay. Some newspaper. We've restored power to this thing. I see that there is not really much going on the other side.
Quit wasting time and get that power on.
Excuse me.
I told you not to worry about me. Just find the terminal and get the power back on to get to Nuka World.
Let's take a quick look back here before we press on.
That's
it. Here we have apparently Bethesda did not think.
Guests, if you're missing an item, stop by our lost and found at the main gate. Your item will be returned to you for a nominal fee.
Bethesda did not think to make that. Rail actually dangerous. So, I don't quite remember which of these things is useful or whatever, so I'm probably grabbing more than I need to. So we have tokens, cups, people, dog tray. Probably a lot of this stuff is just paper. Okay, now we're gonna hop on the train.
Nuka World's Great Halloween Spooktacular will begin next week. Reserve your tickets for this nighttime event at the main box office.
Oh, we might need to use that terminal again. Oh, and we do. The quest marker is kind of indicative. There's something else we must do with the terminal to get stuff going. Now this is a fun cinematic scene. You don't often get these in Fallout games.
Hello, and on behalf of the Nuka-Cola Corporation, we'd like to welcome each and every one of you
the window,
aboard the Nuka Express monorail. For your own safety, please remain seated or utilize the provided handrail while the train is in motion. If you'll direct your attention to the right side of the monorail, you can observe Nuka World's famous Biztop Mountain. Standing at over 100 meters tall, Biztop Mountain is the largest man-made structure in Nuka World and features the 5-star Biztop Grill.
This is showing me areas that you can't actually go to.
Coming up in the heart of Nuka World, Nuka Town, USA.
I at least strongly suspected it, and it's always a little bit bummer when you end up having that situation.
So, Harvey bagged another sucker to help his family. Can't believe that gag still works. I only got a minute, so you better listen, and listen good. Name's Gage, Porter Gage, and the truth is, you've been set up. But if you somehow make it through alive, I have an interesting offer for you. In the meantime, have fun and put on a good show. I'll be watching.
Yeah, just I really enjoy.
We are now arriving at the station.
Things.
Please be sure to collect any children and personal belongings before exiting the Nuka Express.
That you can't go to. But it turns out.
Attention all live viewers, we're under design rules out there. In case you haven't noticed, it looks like we got ourselves some fresh meat to run the gauntlet.
Is there a reason the hairs on your neck are standing up like that?
Yes, I just got sent into a trap, Ada. It's not a good thing. And then threatening messages. In that terminal, there's some water in case I get thirsty. How thoughtful. Thanks, Raiders. Okay, so what we have here is an elevator that does not work, a bunch of skeletons, and a terminal with threatening messages, and not a whole lot else going on.
And she's off! Let's hope our latest break and draw a little inspiration from our previous victims.
People bragging about how scary this place
is. Make sure you don't leave anything useful behind.
It's not good. Fortunately. Okay, something got me there. I'm not sure what. Wow.
Attention all my favorite undesirables out there. In case you haven't noticed, looks like we got ourselves some fresh meat to run the gauntlet.
Well, let's get the purified water again. This time, we'll have to pay a little bit more attention as to what might kill us. But I didn't even see what killed me there, and that is a bummer. Okay, we are at full health.
And she's off! Let's hope our latest break and draw a little inspiration from our previous victims.
Ugh. Chained on the other side.
What can do about that? Laser turret. We can't really do anything about it.
May as well take what we can. They won't be needing those items any longer.
The game there. Okay. Nobody is seeing us right now. Probably good. Ada unfortunately landed on the other side of that wall. But okay, so we have dead gunners.
Jesus, who's torturing who? Pick up the pace, Vic.
Yeah. lot of, and fire, and now we can get a few shots in.
Oh, let's get a move on! Doesn't matter what you do, the gauntlet gets them all. Yeah.
Very careful and methodical. These perks make me so violent. Okay, we'll get this one. Okay, there we go. So there's one foe left, probably another turret. Cannot see it right now, but it is probably there. Winding your way through here. Move it up. Okay, so with master locks, unlike all the other locks, you often don't get them on your first shot. You gotta be very careful and remember exactly
what
areas gave you.
So our little Vic managed to pick one tiny little lock. Let's see how long the gauntlet lets her enjoy that one. Dangerous that way. Might be wrong. Okay.
Austin Springs. Awesome. Sweet. So that, I think, is everything just happened. You can see it.
What the hell? I see Pat Brahma go faster than this, Vic.
You can see a nice view of the outside here. It doesn't actually look all that pretty from this angle, but this part of the world actually is rather pretty. Up we go. We're still gonna be careful. Those disgusting dead bodies.
I suggest we take as much as we can carry.
To lean in and get that, but it's doable.
It's decision time! All doors lead to death. Some just a little slower than others.
Okay, three doors. Can't really see what's behind the door, so Ada.
I'd be happy to help if I can.
Take a look.
I'll take care of it.
Let my robot open the door.
Hold.
No problem.
Go check that out.
Certainly. If this area is even possible without good lock picking skills.
Got it.
Okay, slipping out, and we're out. Okay, now we will move our rat away.
Someone thinks she's a real tough gal, eh? But the gauntlet ain't through with her yet.
Okay, so you can see. Build some exterior stuff to force you down underneath this place. The access tunnels, where we're gonna go. The this as possible.
Sweet.
And that is it. Here we actually told it to activate, but I'm wondering if it's working on reverse psychology of some sort. Maybe not, but... Carrot. Noodle cup. So it looks like previous people did come through here. They slept here
for... This bitch takes any longer, we're all gonna die of boredom!
Oh, I'm sorry. You're not putting on a good show. Here is that the raiders are kind of complacent, and they are still gathering all this stuff to live their raider lifestyle, but they're spending it on idle entertainments, which feels a little bit like maybe it's a critique of modern society, that we probably have more than enough resources for everybody to live happily, and now are concerned
for... I suggest we take as much as we can carry.
But I don't think that it's actually a particularly strong critique. Doesn't give a great answer as to why it might be bad to live your life looking for a certain amount of entertainment.
Outsmarted by a monkey! Not our victim's best moment, but unfortunately...
Pressing forward, we... see what we have here.
Yes. Playthroughs, I know that is a pretty annoying trap. There's some neat mods out there that let you build those.
Jesus, who's torturing who? Pick up the pace, Vic!
Okay, and we'll see if we can just climb up here and... Where are we going? Look how fast that is. There are some moving lights down there. This would be very clever, except I don't quite know what I'm doing with it. I think I am skipping some things that... There's some... drop.
What the hell? I see Pat Brahma go faster than this. Time for things to get dangerous. See if she survives. What's next? Fortunately, I think I got the sneaking perks enough that these will never go off for me. So basically, all this is free mind. I would not be surprised if this activates and turns against me, but I will be able to attack it. Inside it. Oh! Let's get a move on! Doesn't matter what you do, the gauntlet gets them all in the end. Is this some kind of joke? I knew we should have put turrets in there!
Yeah, the light step perk. I wonder if the Guardian is what activated that.
Protect and serve.
That might be a problem. Yeah, looks like it is. But if I'm careful and move in the right directions, maybe far enough.
Come on, Vic! While we're young here!
Ada's gonna heal me right up with her. And something else got on fire, I'm not quite sure what. Okay, so. Yep.
Kill. Kill.
Electron Guardian here is almost dead. And we're gonna just tell it to cut down. I'm gonna see if I can make it across here.
For the odd noises I'm currently emitting, a consequence of being mechanical in nature.
Okay, there was something exploding. I think this is the trip through if you fall down. Bowling balls are occasionally useful later on, red boxes less so. Bomb. Open the door. And we're gonna save.
If you find any spare parts, you be sure to let me know.
What the hell? I've seen Pat Brahma go faster than this, Vic!
Okay, so another thing you'll notice, there are grenade bouquets hanging from the ceiling all over the place here. One of the things I tried, and it went hilariously wrong, I think one of the first few times I made it through here is to just assume that if I ran fast enough, everything would be all right. That was so incredibly not true. But in a lot of Fallout adventures, it is true. It's just the sheer quantity here means that the sheer quantity of the explosives here meant that in that one case, in this one case, they actually set up everything correctly. Made for a series of traps that did end up being deadly if you just try to sprint all the way through. Frag grenade. Frag grenades.
Let's take a look.
Come on, Vic.
Not very overloaded, but overloaded enough that our junk over. Apparently, it's the vast majority of our weight.
How are we young here?
I'm guessing they're calling me Vic.
Someone thinks she's clever. Time for a little reality check.
Okay, so we have. Apparently, the air is getting poisonous. I'm just chilling out and picking a lock.
Let's see if Vic can kill the gas before the gas kills her.
One turn.
Let's take him out.
So we have a terminal, we had a valve thingy. Crossbow. None of that. Your OSSBOW. This is plausible.
Through.
Okay. Everything is offline. Everything is busted. Well, we can at least open the door. So let's open the door. Not quite sure what I'm doing here. Move, move, move. Okay, so Sergeant Marks, that apparently is a previous victim here.
Got it.
Don't need that. Let's see what's going on over here.
Oh, let's get a move on. Doesn't matter what you do, the gauntlet gets them all in the end.
Might have been the password to where we just were, maybe. Some blue, get some stuff. Oh my goodness, that is terrifying. A giant ant. That's actually one of the few things that really...
Jesus, who's torturing who? Pick up the pace, Vic!
It's really stomach-churningly awful. Okay, let's open up this door. I'm not sure I've ever noticed this before. Previous playthroughs. Oh, come on. Okay, that is the right
nice.
Angle. But it's chained. To take a little bit of a nap. Paper. Caps. Or cigarettes. Okay. I don't think I picked up any armor, otherwise I probably would want to break it down. That armor, thingy. Okay. Here is a grid up above.
What the God damn! Look who's in the whole stretch! Time for a whole audience presentation!
Grab it. Apparently not. So, that is the gauntlet. Now we are finally...
Well, I'll be damned! You know what that sound means? Get your ass down to Cola Cars! The main event's about to begin!
We are finally at the end of the gauntlet. I'm guessing that the entrance that was used for this part was a maintenance tunnel of some sort. See, somebody's working on some fire.
You got me wired up yet, Gage?
Yeah, boss.
Finally. Now go shut off that damn alarm.
All right. I'm on it.
Now where? There's my next victim now. Don't look like much. Here's a quick rundown how this works. You go stock up, make yourself presentable. Then we're gonna give these folks a show. A show where I decorate these walls here with your lovely brains. Thanks to this suit, I'm the only one that wins this fight. Period. Think you're hot shit getting this far. Think again. All right, Gage. Let her through. Something tells me I'm really gonna enjoy this.
Okay. Well, down we go. Down we go.
It's almost time. After a run like that.
Sweet.
About to be the best slaughter yet. Remember, longest survival time against Coulter still stands at 1 minute 37 seconds.
Okay, well, let's see if we can beat that.
Get over to Cola Cars and watch Coulter crush our latest pick. Unless you don't like fun. And who here in Nuka World doesn't like fun?
Alright, listen the hell up. If you want to make it out of this alive, I've only got a minute. Find the intercom on the wall. I'll make it quick. Got a death wish or something?
Who is this?
I'm the guy that's gonna get you out.
All right, I'm listening.
My kind of gal. Look, damn thing's invincible.
Yeah, I wouldn't expect it.
You want to win?
Okay, so he suggests that I grab a weapon from the lockers to deal with this impossible fight. I'm not think he's talking about that man.
Hey, how may I be of service? Take that weapon.
I'll get it done.
Because those are worth a pretty penny.
Gun?
That ought to help. Yeah, I know what it looks like. You're just going to have to trust me.
I've always wanted one of these. I made a great toy for Sean.
Oh, great. You're a lucky day. Mm-hmm. Once the water hits Coulter, it'll kill his defenses.
Staying hydrated is half the battle, right?
He ain't got a choice. Alright.
Okay, so here we go. We are going to go and face the man, very well armed, ourselves. First face. yeah. Chemist is kind of tempting. Or we could start on that cap collector stuff. We can't do the next level sneak. Can't do the next level armor. So we could either do chems, or we could do... actually, we're going to do chems. The reason for this is not the direct advertised effect. It is that we can build, we can make more chems. Like, with the chemistry skill at a workstation. You can craft chems.
Disciples, are you ready for blood?
Gate.
You better know.
Hey.
Yes, ma'am.
Grab that. Get that.
I'll get it done.
Pick that up.
Certainly.
Take that.
I'll take care of it.
she'll
it
get
would be my pleasure
respect
to assist
when
you,
she
ma'am.
Earns respect.
Amen.
All right, all right. Now get the hell out of here. I'll show the boss around.
What did I tell you? Work like a charm.
Death by squirt gun. I'd love to see the message on his tombstone.
Tell me about it. I wish I had a better... I get that you have no idea. Taking out Colder wasn't just... Now that he's actually gone, we've got ourselves... All I'm asking is...
Sure, sure.
All right, all right. There are three rates... And yeah, if the... Thanks to Colder, I think you have...
Sounds like fun. Count me in.
That's the spirit.
Sure.
Now, I'm sure you meet me at the overpass. Just let me get that there.
Okay. So, we've cleared the gauntlet, I think. Yes. And we now, roughly speaking, have our run of Nuka World. It's not quite always as simple as that, and there's a whole lot of stuff to do. But we are now, at least initially, trusted by the Raider gangs. And we can go out into that world that we saw on the trolley car. And we're out. I'm wondering if we can fast travel back to the Commonwealth yet. Looks like we can. Cool. But first we actually will go and see Gage.
We expect you to show a little appreciation. We make sure you've got enough to eat and drink. We provide security.
We can see
without us,
yes.
You'd be food
they
for the bloodworms.
Ain't no one sad about Colder. Just don't screw this up.
Caught one of the traitors stealing food.
Yeah? What did you do to him?
Turned him loose outside the gate.
You serious?
Yeah. Then
Mason
I got in
tarred and feathered the last alphas.
Don't traitor.
And it's smart to go ask him. So let me get this straight. Some scaver makes it through the gauntlet.
We'd all consider putting a bullet in
target practice.
You haven't seen anything that's out of the ordinary around here, have you? Maybe something hidden.
I thought we told
Nuka
you.
Nuka World. I've always dreamed of coming here.
Something you can find it there, like everyone.
Doesn't see
what? Sure.
You can just the name Sierra Petra. I traveled all. Maybe you've heard about my.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Really? That's... You just made...
Right.
Well, I'd stay and chat some...
If you're searching for a more ridiculous...
Sunglasses? Oh, aren't they great? Oh, I...
Uh-huh. I...
Oh, nothing.
Uh-huh. I'm a fellow...
Wow, really? I've read all... How about...
Sounds like...
Okay. Right this way. I'm not here for the...
Hey, Sierra.
Suppose you came here
Hello
for
again. Yes,
here.
I'm still...
So if you want to live, I suggest you stay where you belong. That last one died too fast.
Okay, so we have a pond. That was a weirdo from the...
Sometimes you gotta ask yourself, how high were they when they built this place?
And this is... Player home, I think. Unless I'm misremembering... Way to get there. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the right way. Here we go. Little place. It's not that useful as a settlement. This is
so good. Man, I love that. I already know what's going on.
isn't this just where I came from? Two of them, of course. I wonder what this place was meant to be before the war. Maybe this wasn't the right. A separate entrance that gets you up there. Oh, right. This is how you do it.
Gage?
Welcome home, boss. The digs are yours now. We hope you like everything you see.
I'm really running the
Now that, right. Look, I'll be honest with you. Sure as hell ain't. My talents are best.
No, sure. I understand.
Angle, but I'm telling you. It ain't. Let's take a step back. Huge. We had a good head start on it. About a year ago, and then the gangs got restless.
I can fix it.
Yeah? Look, I know these gangs. First thing you gotta
Sure.
You don't have to trust.
Have any advice?
Yeah, all right. The operators are in it mostly. The pack.
They'll listen.
Okay, settle down. Look.
Right?
Just.
Okay.
All right. You just need to. I'll be here if you need me.
Okay. So.
Hey, Gage.
You need something, boss?
Tell me more.
Yeah. Yeah. What took a shit. If I were you, then you've got the operator. And then there's up to you. You need any.
Aren't you raiders?
Hey, come on. Commonwealth. Ain't or I've run. I make a.
They just need a good.
Well, that's the difference.
Sure.
Anyway, don't miss
right?
gangs out here. You need any.
Nothing else for now.
All right.
Okay, so I don't remember what you have to do to actually get him to go with you. At some point, he'll do it. It might be after you meet with all of the gang markers, all of the gang bosses. But for now, we've done the basics, and I think that means that once I drop stuff off. Home, which in this case is Red Rocket Truck Shop. Whoop, there are enemies nearby, apparently. Not quite sure where, but...
Take them down!
Oh, some raiders.
Make sure you don't leave anything useful behind.
Okay, so now we'll go to Red Rocket Truck Shop. Truck stop? Shop? Stop? Probably stop.
Heads up.
What can I do for you? Glad to be of service.
Now, the third sapper, it doesn't actually do any damage. Because practically no foes in the game are weak to water damage or actually take any damage at all from it. But I find it to be pretty hilarious, so I tend to keep that weapon on me, even though it weighs, doesn't weigh a lot. I guess 2 pounds. But I love how ridiculous it is. Ant meat, not super useful for almond meat. up getting a decent amount of Nuka-Cola. Not quite sure. I'm weighed down a little bit more than I'm used to. And it's a little bit more... Oh, maybe it's all these grenades. Yeah, weigh a decent bit. Don't need all these Molotovs anymore. I guess I got well more than I needed. And let's take a quick look at the mods that you can do on the first set. No, I have not unlocked any mods for the first sapper yet. It's definitely a short-range weapon. Okay, so that is it. We have been to Nuka World.
Hey, buddy.
Greetings, buddy.
From the gauntlet.
Would you like a cold one, or did you want to hear a joke?
I'll take a beer.
Cold.
Always good to keep getting more of those, because there are some points in the game where you desperately need action points. And these are a pretty good way to get it. Maybe some of this is purified water and other stuff I've just picked up. Yeah, so that is the next step in our Fallout 4. In our next video, I'm thinking about getting Gage as my companion, because he is quite a good he has quite a good perk, and he's also quite powerful. So, I will see you then. Bye.